Hey curl friends, and welcome back. So today I'm going to show you guys my braid pattern for a middle part U-part wig with leave out. So you guys know I have super thick hair, so I like to start off on really old stretched hair. This is a really old twist out and I just took it down from my hair protector cap. I'm creating that middle part to begin with, and then I will be pulling out between 1.5 to 2 inches of hair on either side of that middle part. This is what I'm going to be leaving out as my leave out. And I just went back in with my rat tail comb, the end of a rat tail comb, just to straighten out that part. I want it to be extremely straight and crisp so that I get a nice base or foundation for my anchor braid. So this is my leave out. I went ahead and just tucked it away. I'm going to wrap the rest of my hair into a low ponytail so that I can work on this leave out. I'm detangling with a detangling brush and using some heat protectant spray to coat my hair before I go in with the blow dryer to stretch my hair as far as possible. I'm using my good old trusty Paul Mitchell blow dryer, and I just have it on between medium and high heat, and I'm just going to stretch my hair. I want it to be as stretched out as possible so that when I go in with my flat iron, it's a really cool and easy process. So I'm coating back the hair with a little bit of argan oil from Arvizalia. This isn't heat protectant as well. I'm just going to go ahead and flat twist that leave out to keep it out of the way and clip it with a hair clip so that I can begin braiding my hair. So our leave out is complete, and I'm just going to go ahead and grab some leave-in conditioner to spray onto the rest of my hair. I just want my hair to be nice and manageable and moist, not super soaking wet or damp, just enough to be able to work through my hair. I'm creating the first part, which is going to be my anchor braid, and I just pretty much pulled out between 1/2 inch to 1 inch of hair on either side as well as the back. I'm using my product that I have coming soon, you guys. It's just a little moisturizer, and I'm just going to go ahead and cornrow that hair from one side to the other. I'm starting on my right side, and I'm just wrapping this braid around the leave out, and then I'll be bringing it towards the front. This braid is going to be our anchor braid. This is the most essential braid for a U-part wig. This is what the actual wig will be attaching to hold and stay put. So I'm just taking that exact braid and I'm bringing it down the side of my face. It's just going to go straight down and all the rest of the braids will follow suit. So I'll just be creating these medium to small size braids and just connect them at the bottom when I get towards my ear. I'm just creating all of the rest of these cornrows off of the anchor braid. I'm starting from the top of that anchor braid and bringing it down towards my ear. As soon as I hit the tip of my ear, I'm just including that braid in the cornrow that I'm already creating to connect them and to get it to lay nice and flat. So that entire left side is complete. I'm moving on to my right side and I'm just repeating the same exact steps. As you guys can see here, I have the cornrow and then I just take the rest of the braids and add them into that cornrow, and then I'll just braid them all the way down to the ends, which will leave me with 2 big plaits. So the front of our hair is complete. We have our anchor braids, our leave out, as well as our sides are laid down flat. And I'm just going in with some Eco Styler gel just to lay down my edges a bit, have them lay nice and flat and polished, and we can move on to the back. So for the back, I'm creating another middle part. I'm going to section it off from left to right. And these back sections, I pretty much just wing it. I usually just create 4 really large cornrows in the back. I just braid them super tight so that they're not super bulky and they lay down pretty close to my scalp. So as you guys can see here, this is the left section and I'm just splitting that into 2 different sections. I'm just going to create that cornrow and I'm going to take that really large plait from the front and include it into this cornrow. This is going to give it a nice flat foundation. I pretty much essentially just want all of the braids to connect in the end. Moving on to my second cornrow for that back left section, I'm just cornrowing it and then I'm going to include the rest of the hair into that 1 big plait. So essentially you'll end up with 1 large plait in the back on the left side as well as 1 large plait in the back on the right side. cornrow all the way down to the ends and create that last cornrow. Include all of the rest of the plaits into the cornrow to create two large plaits. If you're not good at braiding your hair or cornrowing your hair at all, you can just cornrow your hair all the way down to the ends and then just sew them together at the very end. But I wanted to keep this super easy and seamless. This is usually how I would just braid down my hair. So here I am with my two big old Pippi Longstocking plaits, and I'm just going to crisscross them in the back and tie them together using a needle and thread. But before I do that, I baste my hair with an oil of my choice. Today I'm using the Tailored Beauty Everything Oil, and I'm just coating my scalp so that I can get a nice, perfect protective style. I crisscross the two plaits over each other in the back, and I sew them down using a needle and thread. To start it off, I go ahead and wrap that needle and thread around the hair, and I go through the loop to make sure that I'm knotting it every single time so that when my hair grows out, the entire braid or foundation does not shift. I want this to be as tacked down as possible. When you're sewing the two braids down, be sure not to overlap them on top of each other, but more so one on the top half and then one on the bottom half, sitting very, very close to each other, but not specifically on top of each other. That way you don't end up with a bulk in the back of your head. And that's pretty much it. So this is pretty much my foundation or braid pattern for a middle part U-part wig with leave out. I'm going to go ahead and flat iron my leave out to blend it with my wig. But I hope you guys enjoyed this. I love you guys, and I'll see you guys in the next video.